Au, buongiorno. So, new vlog. We are in Switzerland. And yesterday I made jam. One type from blackberries and one type from raspberries and red currant. It's always so difficult to remember the names of the berries in the different languages. But anyhow, I made them and I wanted to show you the colors. This is the black currant. But first of all, coffee. So these are the two jars that are waiting for me. If you see some videos that try to explain you what you have to make differently when using an Italian mocha, bialetti, or same principle, don't. You fill the water up to there, you fill the coffee up to there without pressing it, you close it, you close the lid, and then you put it on the stove, and you don't need to open the lid. They say you have to open the lid because then you see when the coffee comes out and is ready. If you have ears to listen, it rants when it's ready. It makes boom, 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 just like an Italian car. And then, you know, it's ready. You don't have to look in it. I never look in it. It makes me angry when people... It's sort of mansplaining on culture level. Those cultures who think they are the best in the world and they are the greatest and whatever, and every country has good things and bad things, and in almost every country they have invented something, or leave other people's or countries' inventions as they are. If you want to do it better, take it, do it better, give it a different name, but don't mansplain the original people how to use it. We know how to use a mocha. This is my ginger turmeric shot that I prepare every now and then. Freeze it in these ice cube bags and then put a cube, a cute cube, in my orange juice in the morning. So still no decision. Toast or no toast? Take out the butter in the meantime. Toast or no toast? What do you think? Toasted or not? Okay. Let's start with this. They look like jewels. That's the blackberry. That is the raspberry with red currant. So, I start with the blackberry jam. The good news is, it tastes like blackberries. What better could you expect from a blackberry jam? It's just like eating the fruit from the bush. And now to the raspberry red currant jam. It's a nice combination. I didn't think of it before. Because it gives them the flavor and the aroma and the sweetness of the raspberries. And then adds this light acid of the red currant. Very good. Just put you on that side now so I can see clearly from which side my nose is looking worse. So, after a nice breakfast, today's plans are that I have to edit a video right now, at least one. My daughter is on her way to come here. She will arrive maybe at 2. And this evening, the two of us are going to the cinema and we are watching the Barbie movie. And I'm very much looking forward to it. It's a real mother-daughter moment, I guess. And we will have sushi at the cinema. Great. So, first of all, editing. This is the camera I'm working with, or the iPhone, where you are right now. No money to buy new equipment, so that's it. Let me show you my view. Isn't that beautiful? A part of the crane back there. But this is my view when I'm sitting at my kitchen table. And I love it so much. So lush, so green, so private. And then all those colorful spots. I love it. Back to work. Baby has arrived. And she's preparing some caprese for us. And I'm preparing the coffee for after the caprese. And then we'll have a nice afternoon and then go to the cinema. Ready for Barbie?
Yes.
Right. Fuchsia, pink, everywhere.
Oh. And no, not here, just for you.
Okay.
I have pink socks on.
I have a pink belt and earrings. Carnival in September.
So, in good old California tradition,
fishing.
Buon appetito.
Aspetta. E tu puoi fare transition.
Transition. Where do we have to go?
I don't know.
Sorry, okay.
Seit Anbeginn der Zeit. Aber die Puppen waren schon immer und ewig Babypuppen. Was durchaus Spaß machen kann. Jedenfalls für eine Weile.
Daughter is going back home and she's taking her plants with her after they stayed here all summer. So we gathered already those who stayed inside, and now she's taking up the ones that are outside. So let me show you. That is the first half.
C'è una lumaca.
Ah, no, appena tolta una. Da dentro però.
Fortunately, it's raining. Good morning. So yesterday we were a bit in a hurry then, of course, as usual. So we packed the Cinquecento with all those plants, and my daughter then left for her apartment, and I went to babysitting for a dear friend of mine, and their daughter is 7 now, and she had her first day at school on Monday, and the school had an evening where the teacher was telling about their vision and mission and strategies and how they do things and so on. So both parents wanted to go there, so my friend and her husband, and I love this idea because it's not always only mom's task or dad's task. They should both know about it. So I had a great time with the daughter, and I'm very proud that apparently I was the first one to make it happen, that the parents didn't have to come back earlier, which of course is mainly due to the fact that she is now older than the last time, which was a year ago. So, but still, I'm proud. She fell asleep and then slept the whole time, and it was great. So then I came home to my empty house, missing my daughter. Today the weather is better again. And today I have a few things to do, starting with a sink in my guest bathroom, which is clogged. Is that the word? So I will open it up and clean it, which we have to do every now and then, right? Okay, so let's see what this thing looks like. Gloves, and then let's hope that I can open it. My biggest problem is always if I can rebuild it the way it was. Okay, so I will clean it in the shower, because afterwards I will clean also the shower sink. Is that the word? Scissor would be good. Not for cutting, but the easiest way to open this is by using scissors. First, we insert that here. Then that here. No, we need you there. You stay there. Fine. Okay. So, the big test. Toilet paper is the best indicator of water. Looks perfect. Perfect. And there we go. It's clean. And I'm happy. The question that I always have in that situation is, as I have all the tools and needed things outside now, and I'm on it, should I do it in my bathroom too. But I guess I don't want to today. I guess I leave it to when it's needed. Those bells. I will go and harvest the quinces. I have a little quince tree that I really love and I wanted it. The point is, I don't like to work the quinces because they are hard as hell. I had had a quince tree before in another house and I did it once. I harvested all of them. I cleaned them because you have to take away the hair and then you have to take away the peel. And then you have to cut them in pieces and then cook them before you can start making any jam or whatever. And those fruits are so hard that when I finished it, my hands were really hurting. They're hard like stones. So I love my quince tree, but fortunately there are many people who love to have them. So a very good friend of mine every year is happy to get them. So I'm harvesting them right now. And then I will give her the quinces and she can do with them whatever she wants. So let's go. So there it is. I already prepared my stepper and my IKEA bag. What would I do without the IKEA bags? And here is the little tree. And as you can see, it has not many fruits, but it has some, and they are beautiful. So I'm going to harvest them. You see? And my friend says the thing she likes the most about my quinces is that they are not so furry. Normally they have just like a skin, like a fur. They're hairy and you have to take that off, which is not difficult, but you have to do the process. And mine are not so furry. That was the one that fell on my head.
I think I got them all.
So let's see what the figs do. Yesterday we picked a lot. Look at this. It's a tree with black figs. And it's the descendant of the fig tree that my grandmother had in her chicken garden. There are a bee and a wasp, two bees and a wasp. They're having a party.
this is our harvest. Look at that. They're beautiful, but an apple is a soft cutie pie in comparison. So I will send a picture to my friend so she knows they are harvested and she can have them delivered or pick them up or whatever she wants.
I had, it's a beautiful day today, and I was thinking what to do because with that beautiful weather, I'm not willing to work inside. I would have some editing work, but I can do that this evening, but I don't like to do it when the sun is shining and the weather is beautiful. And that is one thing my mother always told me when we went to Germany. This is not Italy, so the weather is always uncertain and you don't know what the next day will bring, so and how long the warm weather will stay. So whenever the sun is shining, go out. And that is what I'm thinking about since a few minutes. But I heard a noise where I didn't know if it was a bee or a wasp, if it was here inside my kitchen or just out there on the veranda, or it was somebody using some instrument. You never know. It was just like bzzz. Could also be, I don't know. So I heard it and I checked and I didn't see anything, and then it stopped and then it came back, and I followed the audio and found out that it was in this old wood stove of my great-grandmother. So I opened all the trays and heard it more, and so I knew it was in there. And then finally I saw it and I got it with a glass and then freed it outside. And as I had also taken out the ashtray, I emptied the ashtray on my compost. And doing that, I found two avocado plants. Which happens every now and then, because of course with all the biological trash, I also throw on the compost the seed of the avocados, and every now and then they sprout and become trees. In one autumn I found 7 or 8 of them in the compost, and I dug them out and planted them. So this is what I'm going to do right now. You come with me? Let's go. So here you see the ashes, and there you see one plant and the other one or two plants.
Here we go. We go. Three little avocado trees. Just like this one and this one, which are two. And this one, which is number three, which suffered a little bit this summer, but it will come back. Put the two small ones in the bigger pot. There you go. I'll go and get some soil from the compost. You know what I'm really proud of? This vine. I just replanted this plant like this. It was just this. Here last year in autumn, and now look at that. It didn't make fruit this year because I guess it had enough to do to grow, and in that direction. This was exactly what I wanted, and it was so kind to make it. And on the other side, I do have passion fruit or flower or plant or which is growing up here. But in autumn I will have to take it down here and put it in the veranda because it doesn't live in winter at temperatures below zero. So, no. And I do have tomatoes. Look at those small tomatoes. Aren't they so cute? I guess I have to put it up a bit. There we go. So, if I just put this in here. And this in there. Should work, right? Right now I saw that the birds don't have anything to eat, so I will feed them.
There you go. So now they have enough to eat and to drink and to take a bath. That's their bathtub. And they use it a lot.
The spa is opened. Some are eating, some are taking a bath, some are waiting in line.
Thank you for your company. I hope you liked that vlog of mine of this week, and I would love to see you next week. If you did like it, please leave me a like and please subscribe to my channel. And in any case, be kind.